All right, now let's talk about something that is usually found not necessarily in the advanced cardiac life support pharmacological drug card specifically, but is vitally important to reperfusion therapies. We're going to talk about fibrinolytic drugs. You see, fibrinolytic drugs, also called thrombolytic drugs, are any medication that's capable of stimulating the dissolution of a blood clot, sometimes referred to as a thrombus. These types of drugs work by activating something referred to as the fibrinolytic pathway. Now, this is important because it differentiates them from anticoagulant drugs, which are commonly known as coumarin derivatives and heparin. Now, these drugs, which prevent the formation of blood clots by suppressing the function of multiple clotting factors that are normal and present in the blood, are different from anticoagulants. The most common indications for the use of fibrinolytic medications include acute myocardial infarction and acute ischemic stroke. In AMI patients, it would be indicated if the ST segment elevation is consistent with an MI of greater than or equal to 1 millimeter in two or more contiguous leads. It may also be indicated if the signs and symptoms of an MI last more than 15 minutes and less than 12 hours, and PCI is not available within 90 minutes of medical contact. Now, if the indication is related to ischemic stroke, patients may qualify if they suffer sudden onset of focal neurological deficit, like slurred speech, facial droop, one-sided weakness, or one-sided paralysis. The stroke symptoms do not seem to be self-resolving, which is kind of what we see when it's a transient ischemic attack, known as a TIA, and the signs and symptoms are present for up to 3 hours, but not greater than 4.5 hours. With fibrinolytic drugs, there are reasons to exclude the use, and they include but may not be limited to the following. Hypertension with systolic blood pressure greater than 180 to 200 millimeters of mercury, a right arm versus left arm blood pressure difference greater than 15 millimeters of mercury, significant head or facial trauma within the past 3 months, prior intracranial hemorrhage, bleeding disorder or internal bleeding within the last 2 to 4 weeks, they're on a current anticoagulant treatment, pregnant, maybe they have ischemic stroke greater than 3 hours or less than 3 months, not to include the current condition being considered for the current fibrinolytic treatment, and serious systemic disease, which would include advanced cancer or kidney disease. So the adult dosage for fibrinolytic treatments can be a little bit complex because the dose of fibrinolytic treatment depends on the fibrinolytic being used.